Oh man, we have our shot of redemption here in the losers bracket. I don't think we can actually keep this hand. It's kind of nice because we have both the Equine Courage and the One Dozen Eyes. That's kind of an expensive combo, you know. Like, we don't really have enough mana. If we had a 2-mana Accelerant, like instead of this Sombra Hoverguard, then the hand would make a little bit more sense. I'm kind of wondering why this Sombra Hoverguard's in the deck. that's what I'm wondering. Looking at this hand, but we're gonna go to six. We are on the draw. One land Wafer's Bauble hand. Let's try it out. I don't really want to go to five, especially since if we hit the second land, then the Wayfarer's Bauble gets us a distance towards where we want to be. And we're on the draw, and we have the Reapin, so to get us to mana five if we had another land off the top. And hand doesn't do very much though, right? Like Tangle Spider and Equine Courage is not really a combo. Maybe we needed like a second One Dozen Eyes or something, just to make the deck a little bit more consistent. I've drafted Ramp into One Dozen Eyes before. It was like quite a long period of time ago, but I remember winning a lot with it. I think the difference is that deck was always green black when I drafted it, and black just wasn't open for this draft, so the ramp strategy just isn't effective. You need to have like some amount of like Echoing Decays or other kinds of removal to buy your time, and our power level is like way lower than it should be, as you can see just looking at this hand. Like, not all of the cards make sense. Okay, opponent goes turn one, Serum Visions. Sure thing, opponent. Yeah, we don't really have Crystal Shard interactions either. Like, we have that awesome card, but not much to do with it. Cool. You'll notice that I kind of saved the seat to play as late as possible. It's because getting a land drop dicked over with a random shatter effect could be pretty brutal. Draw land, just like we drew it up. I think I'm gonna get an island here, as opposed to the one swamp, just so that we can actually cast this Spire Golem. We might need a second blue source at some point too. We'll take one. Now I'm gonna get the swamp. Since we drew another island naturally. It always feels weird to me when this card comes into play untapped. I think I'm used to getting Cloud Post with Reapin, so I think Cloud Post comes into play tapped. So I'm just used to seeing the land enter the battlefield tapped. Sky Under Patrol. That's a good start. If he could have gone turn two Gold Mirror, turn three this card, that would be a pretty brutal opener. I don't hate playing the Spire Golem first, because then if he attacks, we block, he plays a trick, we have Echoing Courage up. I think just passing with a pile of mana open, he might like play some equipment or something and tap low though, and run into the spider. Along came a spider and sat down beside her. Sure, man. You have a Den Guard. Oh, Gold Mirror doesn't serve. Interesting. He has effects in the Declare Attack step. It's +1/+1 until end of turn. Oh no! That's randomly, like, really good against what I want to do. Because it makes it a 3-4. Well, I want to... Whereas I could, like, block it and eat it otherwise. Well, I can still eat this thing. And then hold off the patrol on later turns. Yeah, Tangle Spider's good. Sometimes it's just like randomly larger than your opponent's creatures, and then it just becomes the filthiest card ever. It wasn't really that in the last match, though, so it was kind of not as good as it usually is. Just give something flying, right? Give something shroud. Well, that is incredibly unexciting, if I do say so myself. Do I serve here? This thing gets plus one, and gets vigilance when it's equipped. So that'll make it a 2/4. Nah, I don't think I serve. Attacking here, it gets in 3 damage, would put him down to 18, and it might induce an attack into the Echoing Courage. He got my Trinket Mage, huh? Not that I think Trinket Mage would have done much in my deck. Like, tutoring for another Wayfarer's Bauble isn't exactly exciting. It'd be a little bit different if I'd gotten, like, an Aether Spellbomb or something sweet. Paradise Mantle? Sure thing, man. Does it get plus one for each? No, it's just a flat. Okay. Flat bonus. Yep. You have a 2/4, man. 2/4 that still can't really attack. Yep. Is it my turn yet? Cool. Oh, that's so good. So, 2/3. Oh, he can pay because he has this. But I can make it so this guy can't. Can't block or whatever. Maybe I should just attack with this, see what he does. Because there's a chance I could just get to Giant Growth it and eat his guy if he blocks. I don't know about that. If he doesn't block, then I can pay 1 to return it and 4 to recast it. But then I'm not holding up Echoing Courage. Yeah, let's see what happens if I do this. Maybe I shouldn't have shown him the loop with my own creatures, because then like I can start serving with Tangle Spider at some point, and they might attack into it. What is his deck? Why is there a Gemstone Array in his deck? What is going on? I suppose you could say the same thing about Urgolem's Eye in my deck, huh? What? Sure. Show you to activate this thing. Dum-da-dum-dum-dum. I'm looking at like my deck and his deck, and I'm trying to figure out which of our decks looks more terrible on paper. So my deck looks pretty bad. Don't get me wrong. It looks just not ideal for anything. Let's try this attack again. seemed to work out last time. Okay. Guess it is a spider that is also an abyss. Yeah, when you're in this situation and your opponent's attacking you for 3 and you're at 19 life, you should either be grouping up all of your creatures to block the creature, and then like maybe my spider just trades for your 1/3, you know, instead of losing a creature every single time I tap it sideways. And even better than that, an even better play is to just take 3 damage a few times, because like 19 life is a lot of life to work with, you know. He must have heard me. I guess he can just remove the counter to pay. Yeah, I'm just gonna let this happen. Like, I would rather have Crystal Shard be available to save my creatures if he has something weird, you know? Yeah, Crystal Shard's just randomly good against some decks. And by some decks, I mean most decks. I'm jealous of his Thought Courier. Alright, that's another dude. You got it, man. This game is kind of a grind, wouldn't you say? That's an Ornithopter. Oh, he's got it. He's got the Build Your Own Birds of Paradise. Ah. So we played at 0 mana, 0/2, and then looted away a sweet flyer. I don't know. I don't get it. So this thing has Shroud. He's at 13. I just save this to go to his dome. If he keeps taking hits from my spider anyway. Could also kill his looter, which might be good. Whoa, we have the blocks. This is just happening? That just happened. He's got, like, if he was gonna jump, like, he's got a... Never mind. I'm sure it's all according to plan. He's gonna cast something stupid off this gemstone array. Darksteel Colossus me. I've cast that card in Limited. Off of Krark Clan Ironworks. Dum 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 dum. Yeah, casting an 11 mana card off of Gemstone Array would be very ambitious. It would work this game. It would 100% work. Like, I'm just attacking with my 3/4 every turn. Okay, well, that's a good card. Let's see if that resolves. This looks like a condescend for more than I can pay. Yeah, that's fine. Maybe I should have led with Essence Drain. And then he condescends that, and then I stick the one dozen eyes. I think I'm in fairly decent shape regardless. Could just get fireballed for 15. Fireball is in this format. Nine mana? What does he want nine mana for? He's totally playing a Darksteel Colossus. Alright. Well, kudos to my opponent. This is probably the most ambitious plan I've ever seen. Yeah, the trample is pretty good because we can't even like block, bounce, or whatever. Whoa, dude! You had some mana available. You probably should have paid the one, man. Probably should have paid the one. I probably would have paid the one. We can't all pay the one, I guess. Someone out there. There has to be a person out there who's not there to pay the one. That was our opponent. Okay. I guess we bring this in again. Should probably just be in the main deck. We've got some real bad ones in here, like Sombra Overguard. This card just doesn't belong in this deck at all. Maybe we should just like have the Lurker in here over something. He seemed aggressive, but not that aggressive. I don't think I need to board the Lurker in. Not like that round one match. Alright. So that happened. My opponent definitely hard cast a... I should have taken out the Morningstar. It doesn't make any sense. So we're on the draw. We have an Urgolem's Eye, which is kind of nice. If we get to cast it on time, then we have 2, 4, 5... Or we have 4 here. Plus 4 would be 8 for the Cumulox. That's an if, like an if we get to cast it on time, though. And these cards aren't helping us with that plan at all. I think we're going to go to 6. That's a keeper. Yeah, this hand looks not embarrassing. not as embarrassing as the rest of the deck. So that's good. It's good to not be incredibly embarrassing. You're making me look stupid. Yeah. We also have Serum Visions. A little bit better than condescending the opponent for 0. I think I'm going to bottom both of these. Yeah. And then next turn, play Silvok Explorer. And then hopefully hit like an Urgolem's Eye or something. Something to ramp into on 4 here. That's why I bottomed the land. Paradise Mantle into the revealed card zone. I'm gonna stick that on a Trinket Mage. Is. Well, I don't particularly feel like bouncing a Trinket Mage, though we do have that option. I'm just going to Dawn's Reflection. A land. That's kind of what we were scrying towards with the Serum Visions. I know we're at 6 mana towards the Living Hive, which needs 8. Whoa, Emissary of Hope. This card could be really good, right? Gain one life for each artifact that player controls. Yeah, that's strong. I guess we can block with Wizard Replica. He's down to one card in hand. Echoing Courage doesn't really help us. We could get Crystal Shard going. I guess we could play both, huh? Crystal Shard wouldn't really get a chance to activate, but it would be in play. Yeah, I don't think this Condescend is gonna counter anything meaningful currently, so getting the Shard in play is a little bit better. It just looks like he's gonna have extra mana available. What is this attack? Okay. I would imagine it'd be the +1/+1 pump spell, but if he took it back, then probably not. Ooh, so he gets to look at three cards here. It's not terrible. I mean, it's kind of bad. It wasn't that bad and limited at its time, I guess. It was a little clunky. Didn't impact the board. All right, I kind of want to cast this Ingot. And then we can just pass. Now we're one mana away from Living Hive. Raise the alarm. Do I want to counter this? He's got one in hand. I kind of do want to counter this. Fewer bodies, less nonsense to deal with. And we get to scry too. So we can set up a land here. Ooh, 1, 2, 3, 4. So Cumulox would only cost 4, right? That seems pretty good. And I can like kind of test the waters, see if he's got a Condescend. I guess we can draw the land and then make our decision based on how much land he has available. I kind of like that plan. Yeah, I guess if he has a Condescend, then oh well, right? We'll do it live. Yes. Oh man. I can't wait to hit him with this 6/6. Living Hive is sweet, man. When it deals combat damage to a player, you get that many 1/1 green insect tokens. And we're holding the Echoing Truth. Oh, he just packs it in. He didn't want to have the fun happen. It was going to be sweet. It was going to be sweet. Our deck is slow. Holy crap, is our deck slow. Like, that was like a turn 6 Living Hive when our only defense was like 1/1/3 flyer or whatever. I'll be very surprised if we get a second win in this draft. We just don't have enough interaction with the opponent's deck to be good, I don't think.